Ukraine wins the Eurovision Song Contest after public vote. This is News Review from BBC Learning English. I'm Rob, and joining me to talk about this story is Roy. Hello, Roy.
Hello, Rob, and hello, everybody. If you would like to test yourself on the vocabulary around this story, all you need to do is head to our website, bbclearningenglish.com, to take a quiz. But now let's hear more about this story from this BBC News report.
Ukraine has won the Eurovision Song Contest, which took place last night in Turin, in Italy. The United Kingdom came second, its best result for more than 20 years, with Sam Ryder's entry Spaceman. The UK won the most votes from the music industry experts, but when the public votes were added, Ukraine's Kalush Orchestra leapt to first place.
So, Ukraine has won the Eurovision Song Contest, with the UK's Sam Ryder coming in second. The Kalush Orchestra from Ukraine won the competition after moving up to first place due to the public vote.
Yes, and we have three words and expressions from the news headlines about this story, haven't we? What are they, please, Roy?
We do. We have warms our heart, glorious rebuke, and in hand.
That's warms our heart, glorious rebuke, and in hand. OK, let's pick that first phrase from your first headline, please.
OK, so our first headline comes from Euronews, and it reads, Eurovision, the support warms our heart, say Ukrainians after music contest triumph.
So that's warms our heart, causes happy and positive feelings.
Yes, so this is a three-word expression. First word, warms, W-A-R-M-S. The second word is a possessive pronoun. So in the headline, it's our, but it could be my, your, his, her, and so on. And the third word is heart, H-E-A-R-T. And it basically means to cause happy feelings.
Okay, so let's break down this phrase and look at the word warms. That means becoming hotter, making it perhaps more pleasant. Are we literally warming our heart up here?
No, we're not. Now, when we talk about warming our heart, we're actually talking about filling it full of kind of happy and positive feelings. So it kind of gives you that warm feeling inside. And sometimes when we're talking about a story, a happy story, we could say it warms our heart, or it could be a heartwarming story.
Yeah, especially like real life stories can warm your heart when you hear some good news. I say it's a bit like your family. Your family lived in Brazil. You've managed to move them over to the UK, so you're reunited. There's a story that warmed my heart, at least, Roy.
Oh, well, thank you. Yeah, after 2.5 to 3 years apart, due to the pandemic and various reasons, we finally got together. So I'm glad you find that heartwarming. You could also say it's an uplifting story. Or even if we're talking sometimes about love, we say that a new love could give you the warm and fuzzies. Now, that fuzzy feeling is that excited feeling, and the warm feeling again is that happiness. So sometimes a new love will give you the warm and fuzzies.
Yeah, so a good news story warms our heart. Good, let's have a summary. Now, in our Lingo Hack program, we had a heartwarming story all about Gaspar the Fox. How can we meet this fox again, Roy?
All you need to do to watch that story is click the link in the description below.
Now, let's move on to your next headline, please.
Yeah, okay, so our next headline comes from the Mail Online, and it reads, the night Europe gave a hug to Ukraine and the UK. Christopher Stevens reflects on a glorious rebuke to Putin as Kyiv wins Eurovision Song Contest while Britain gets best result for 20 years. But France and Germany just avoid nil pois.
That's glorious rebuke. Admirable act of criticising someone's words or actions.
Okay, so this is a two-word expression. First word is glorious, G-L-O-R-I-O-U-S. Second word, rebuke, R-E-B-U-K-E. And rebuke basically means speaking to someone in an angry way, very strongly about something they've said or they've done. And glorious relates to that criticism being magnificent.
So if we look at that second word, rebuke, Now, this is quite a strong way of speaking to someone, isn't it?
Yes. So this means to speak to someone angrily about what they've said or they've done, effectively giving them some strong, very strong criticism. Now, that word rebuke can be used as it is as a noun in the headline, or it can be also used as a verb. So, for example, your boss could rebuke you for a bad performance on a project.
Okay. Is there an alternative to that word rebuke?
Well, rebuke is quite formal. Another formal word is berate. Or informally, you could lay into somebody. So my boss laid into me for my bad performance, but that can also be used both physically and verbally. So be careful with that one. Another way of saying it is to lecture someone or give someone a lecture.
And let's talk about that word glorious, because we talked about glorious rebuke. Glorious, I associate with the weather. When the sun's out, we have a beautiful day. It's a glorious day.
That's right. The word glorious can mean something like amazing. It's very positive. It's quite a formal word, and it can mean something like amazing, magnificent, or fantastic. And if I wanted to say, use it informally, I might just say it's an awesome day. And also that word glorious can be used as it is in the headline, talking about admiration, expressing admiration.
Well, your explanation was glorious. Let's have a summary. We discuss all kinds of topics on News Review, and recently we were asking, what is the future for fuel? How can we watch that video again, Roy?
All you need to do is click on the link in the description below.
Right, let's look at your next headline now, please.
Okay, so our next headline comes from ABC News, and it reads, Eurovision win in hand, Ukraine band releases new war video.
In hand, obtained.
Okay, so this is a two-word expression. First word in, I-N, second word hand, H-A-N-D. And it basically means obtained, received, or got.
But we're not looking at this literally, are we? They haven't actually got something in their hand, have they?
Well, yes and no. For example, when you win something, sometimes you receive an award or a kind of trophy that would be held in your hand. But in the terms of the headline, no, we're not really talking about a literal meaning. It's just being used to say that they have won, that the results are now theirs.
Okay, so we're using it here to talk about a win. What else can we use that expression for?
Well, we often use it to talk about, to say we've obtained or received or got positive results. So as you said, you can talk about wins, a win in hand. You can talk about results in hand. For example, at school, if you take exams and you get all of the marks or grades that you need, you can say, I have the grades I need in hand.
Yeah, and what are the other uses of in hand?
Well, in hand can be used to say that something is under control. So if there's a bad situation and the security take control of the situation, you can say that the security guards have got the situation in hand. Another way we can use it is to say that something is in progress. It's got a similar idea of being under control. If you're at work and there's some work that needs doing, a job that needs doing, you can say that the work is in hand or the job is in hand, which means that someone is working on it.
Well, luckily we have this program in hand and we have a summary for you. Now, Roy, please, could you recap the vocabulary and expressions that we've been talking about today, please?
Of course I can. We had warms our heart, causes positive and happy feelings. We had glorious rebuke, admirable act of criticizing someone's words or actions. And we had in hand, obtained.
Now, if you want to test your understanding on the expressions we've discussed today, then we have a quiz on our website at bbclearningenglish.com. And that's a good place to go to for lots of other learning English resources. And don't forget, you can check us out on social media as well. Well, that's the end of News Review for today. Thank you so much for watching, and we'll see you next time. Goodbye.
Bye.